Hello students, welcome to the new lecture session. Myself, Shonkho Ghosh, Assistant Professor of Automobile Engineering Department at Dr. Sudhir Chandra Shur Degree Engineering College under the JIS group. Today, we'll start the second module of Automobile Engine. Basically, the Automobile Engine is a subject for the diploma second year third sem students. The name of the module is Constructional Features, Function and Working of Automobile Engine Components. So students, this is an important chapter for the automobile engineer. To study this automobile engine, this is the most important chapter to understand about the various automobile engine components and its features, constructional features, function and the working. In this chapter or in this module, we discuss on cylinder block. Discuss on the cylinder block, then we will discuss on the piston, connecting rod, crankshaft, camshaft, timing gear, valve, various kind of valve timing, various kind of manifold, silencer, flywheel and the dampers. The objectives of these chapters are to identify the automobile engine components, to understand the working features of this automobile engine components and its constructional features. And the outcomes of this chapter is that students can easily able to identify the various components of the automobile engine. Then they can easily understand the function. They can easily different the various kinds of automobile engine according to their functions, and they can easily understand the what kind of material is used for the what kind of for the various kinds various work automobile engine components. So students, now let's the today's class on this topic, on this from this module 2, that is constructional features, functions and working of the automobile engine components. And the today's topic is cylinder block. So student, let's start out the cylinder block. Introduction. Production of power is the primary function of an engine. Production of power is the primary function of an engine. In order to determine how well an engine is performing, or to compare the performance of one engine with that of other engines, it is necessary to obtain the various results and express them in the standard engineering terms and the parameters, which are used as an indicators of the performance. So students, engine is a most important part of an automobile, and this engine is also called as the heart of the engine. Here, as you can see here, this is the cylinder block. As you can see, this is a cylinder block and this is the exploit view of the engine. So this one is the oil pan, this one is the oil pan drain nut, this is the washer, this one is the gasket, oil pan gasket, this one is the engine block or the cylinder block, this engine block, this one is the cylinder gasket, cylinder head cover, cylinder head cover gasket, manifold, its gas inlet intake manifold and its gasket, exhaust manifold and its gasket, distributor, distributor O-ring, time belt, pulley drive, water pump, oil filter, camshaft pulley. So students, these are the various components of the engine. Now start with the cylinder block. The cylinder block is the cylinder block is the portion. The cylinder block is the portion of the engine. In between the cylinder head and oil sump. In between the cylinder head and the oil sump. And is the supporting structure for the entire, and it is the supporting structure for the entire engine. All the engine parts are mounted on it. All the engine parts are mounted on it or in it, and this holds the parts in alignment. A large diameter hole in the block casting from the cylinder bore. The large diameter holes in the block casting form the cylinder bores, and it requires to guide the piston. These holes are called bore, and as they are made by the boring. So in the large diameter holes of this engine block is called as bore, and it is required to guide the piston. The cylinders are provided with the web or bulkhead to support the crankshaft and the head attachment. So this cylinder basically provide with the web or the bulkhead to support the crankshaft. Here it is supported inside this crankshaft and the head attachment on this side. So each bearing bulkhead support both. Each bearing bulkhead supports both a cam bearing and a main bearing. And the bulkhead is well ribbed to support and distribute the load applied to it. And this gives the block structural rigidity and the beam stiffness. So students, gives the block structural rigidity and the beam stiffness, bulkhead has to be ribbed to support and distribute the loads which is applied on it. So it is the most important things. The cylinders are surrounded by the cooling spaces. The cylinder is basically surrounded by a cooling cooling passages. And the block has drilled passages for the flow of coolant and lubricating oil separately. So from here we can find that the block has the two different drill passages for one for the flow of the coolant and another for the flow of lubricating oil. So they are the two different drill. When a car passage is needed intersecting drill holes are used. Intersecting drill are used to make a curve, to make a curved passage. After the oil holes are drilled, the unneeded open ends are capped. The unneeded open ends are capped by the pipe plug or the steel ball or cup type the soft spot plug. So students, during the creating a curved passage, so we cover during the curved passage, there are which is unnecessary, we make some few ends which is for the during the making of the curved passages for the lubricating oil, well, unnecessarily or unwantedly there are created some various openings, so which is not required for this engine block or the engine block. So that unneeded open ends has to be filled up with the pipe plugs or steel balls or the cup type soft plugs. The head pan and the timing cover are fixed on the block. I mean cylinder head, oil pan and the timing cover. These are the fixed to the block with the seal joint for eliminating the leakage. The gaskets are used in the joints. To take up machine irregularities and to absorb the variation due to the pressure and the temperature extremities. So students, on the engine cylinder block, cylinder head, oil pan, timing gear and the other features are fixed with the engine block or cylinder block with the help of the gasket to take up the machine irregularities and to absorb the variation due to the pressure and the temperature extremes. So that is the reason for the using of the gaskets on these joints. All the major engine components, are installed on or in the engine block. So these components, including cylinder bores, are machined very precisely, which is the largest diameter of the engine cylinder, and they must be thick, and they must be thick enough to contain the pressure and burning the fuel mixture. If it is made by very thin, so it will be deformed. So therefore, it should be thick enough to contain the pressure and of the burning of the fuel mixture. A tight fit must be ensured. In between the cylinder base and the piston ring to enable the piston ring to seal the combustible gas. So a tight fit, just because of not need to passes the combustible gas from the engine combustion chamber to the crankcase so for that reason we need a tight fit which is ensured in between. Because this tight fit is ensured the cylinder base and the piston ring to enable the piston ring and the piston ring. To enable the piston ring to seal this combustible gas to seal the combustible gas from the cylinder combustion chamber to the crankcase. If the cylinder becomes oval due to the wear or some of the gas wear, then some of the gas escapes through the piston. So as I told here to prevent the passage of combustible gas from the combustion chamber to the crankcase, a tight fist is required, and this tight fist is provide the cylinder base and the piston ring. If the cylinder becomes in oval shape, then the combustible gas is leaked from combustion chamber to the crankcase. So this is a combustion chamber, and this gas which leaks through this piston ring, and it is called by the blow by. So this is called by the blow by, and this gas which is called as a blow by is reduces the engine's efficiency, and the finishing of the cylinder wall also affect the ring seal, and this affect the ring seal. The cylinder walls are machined to provide a very smooth finish. Special grinding stones are produced the small groups in the cylinder wall with the collector oil. And these groups help to lubricate the piston ring. And the piston scuds. So previously, most cylinder blocks are made. So students, basically the cylinders are machined to provide a very smooth, precise, and smooth finish. And there are special grinding tools used to produce a small groups, and these groups helps to passing the oil to the piston ring and the piston scud. So previously most the cylinder blocks were made of cast iron or gray iron. As the materials was easy to machine, as the material is easy to machine. So for this reason, most of the cylinder blocks are basically made of the cast iron or the gray iron. The aluminum pistons were very well as against the cast iron cylinder wall. So nowadays, in spite of the cast iron, aluminum pistons. So now aluminum pistons were very well against the cast iron block, and the aluminum piston skin rubbing against the aluminum cylinder wall and wear very quickly. The aluminum block weight much less than a cast iron block. So here basically in the previous section, in the previous, cylinder blocks are basically made of, cylinder blocks are basically made of cast iron or gray iron, which is helps to easy to machine. But when we started the use of the aluminium pistons, so it is against the cast iron cylinder wall, so there are some disadvantages showing. There are some wear is happens occurs the wear is showing on the aluminium piston due to the cast iron cylinder one. So the main advantage of this iron being is, so the main disadvantage of the iron being is its weight. So engine blocks are now being the cast from the lightweighted aluminium. So researchers are wanted to reduce the weight of the vehicle. They try to reduce the weight of the engine. So for this reason, they converted the material from the cast iron to the aluminium to make the cylinder block. Then an aluminium block weighs much less than a cast iron block. An aluminium piston skin rubbing against the aluminium cylinder wall and wear the very quickly. Most aluminium cylinder blocks are fitted with the steel or the ductile iron cylinder bore liner. So most aluminium cylinder blocks are fitted with steel or ductile iron cylinder bore liners. Now coming to the cylinder liner. The cylinder liner is a sleeve. The cylinder liner is a sleeve in which the piston of an engine reciprocates. The liner increases cylinder bore's life. As this can be the made of the iron and suitable more for its wearing property than for its casting properties. The life of a cylinder in between rebores. And depends on the two factor. First one is abrasion, and second one is the corrosion. So these are the two main factors which is basically depends the rebore of a with this. Basically these are the two main factors, the life of the cylinders in the rebores. So abrasion basically depends on the atmospheric condition, and the efficiency of the air filter and the oil filter. So basically atmospheric condition, efficiency of air filter and oil filter is the reason for the abrasion. Now coming to the corrosion. So this abrasion, just the dusty atmospheric air, for this abrasion the dusty atmospheric air is more harmful. Dusty atmospheric air is more harmful as it increases the as it increases the aversion in the cylinder. So there are the two main factors which is depends the life which is depends the life of cylinder between its rebore. They are aversion and the corrosion, where aversion depends on the atmospheric condition and the atmospheric condition and the efficiency of the air filter and oil filter. The dusty atmospheric air is more harmful as it increases aversion in the cylinder. Now coming to the second one, that is corrosion. So corrosion of the cylinder is caused due to the corrosive products of combustion, and which are formed after the burning of the fuel with the air. So students, after the burning of fuel with air, a corrosive products is occurs, and just because of this corrosive products, corrosion on the cylinder liner is showing. So the corrosion is accelerated at the low cylinder pressure, and due to the acid bearing moisture on the cylinder wall. And the use of the separate barrels or the sleeves, and the use of the separate barrel and the sleeves, which is called as the cylinder liner, and provides a long life, and it provides the long life to the cylinder. And these cylinders are cylinder liners, these cylinder liners are made of the superior material and are refitted and are fitted in the cylinder block. The liners are removable and it can be replaced when worn or damaged. The cylinder liners should have good wear resistance and the ability of retain oil to lubricate the surface in between the wall and the piston rings. So students, here you can study the about the corrosion. Coming to the material which is used for the cylinder liner, the most commonly used cylinder liner materials are nitride steel, nitride cast iron, and heat treated chromium and the other alloy of cast irons. For the cylinder liner, nickel chromium has been popularly used. And the nickel chromium iron used contains, and the nickel chromium iron used contain used this Sorry. The nickel chromium iron is usually used, and the contents is here carbon in the percentage of 3.5 or 3.5%. Manganese is 0.6 in percentage. Phosphorus 1.5%. Sulfur 0.05%. Silicon 2%. Nickel 2%. And chromium 0.7%. So to increase the wear resistance, the liners are, the cylinder liners are hardened by heating, to 855 degree centigrade, 855 degree centigrade to 865 degree centigrade for the 30 to 80 minutes and then quenched in the oil. So due to the, after doing this, it increases the wear resistance of the cylinder liner. And by such heat treatment, the life of the liners is increased 3 times as compared with the gray iron or the cast iron cylinder. So by such heat treatment, the life of the liner, cylinder liner, is increased 3 times. Increased 3 times as compared with the gray iron or the cast iron cylinders. So students, today we will discuss about the cylinder block, cylinder liner and its material. In the next class we will continue the cylinder, where we discuss the various kinds of cylinder liner, their comparison, and we also discuss the cylinder head and case and their material. So still then, stay at home and stay safe. Thank you. Thank you so much, class.